views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Praise God for allowing the Holy Spirit to be my guide in my life.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Well, before I get started with the devotion and everything, I just want to say we have been having Bible study on Wednesdays. It's been from 7:30 to 8:30, and we have been going over the book of Revelations. And it has been a tremendous time that we have been having going over this book. It is awesome. It's all about the Lord. If you want to tune in, if you can't make it here on Wednesdays from 7:30 to 8:30, we just here an hour, 1613 West Main, we just here an hour. We're going over the book of Revelation. If you can't get here, we're also doing a Facebook Live. And I believe the Facebook Live is West Main's Heart to Heart. So you look up that on Facebook, West Main Heart to Heart, and you will find us on there Wednesdays. We're going through the book of Revelations, and it's just been a tremendous, tremendous thing. I mean, we have been, the Lord has been in the house the days. It's only been 2 weeks. We've been doing it for 2 weeks. I don't know how long we're going to go till we finish it. We're in chapter one of Revelations. It's just awesome. It's been so awesome. The Lord has been revealing things to me that I didn't know about in Revelations. So it's just an awesome time. So if you want to come out, 1613 West Main, 7:30 every Wednesday. We're only here an hour. If you can't make it, tune in. 7:30, West Main, Heart to Heart on Facebook, and you'll catch us there also doing a live. All right, Wes?
Also to add, it's going to be on SAS 2 here in a couple of weeks. It's going to be on the channels, TV station too.
It's going to be what channel?
Comcast
57,
Frontier 27.
Channel 27. It will be on there on Tuesdays?
That is what they talk on Tuesdays.
On Tuesdays. I don't know the time. On Tuesday, check out Channel Comcast, Channel 55, and Frontier, Channel 27. And we'll be on there. I don't have the time right now, but we'll get that to you. But check us out, because it's an awesome time we're having, learning what the Lord wants us to learn out of Revelation. Okay, so now we're going to get into the devotional. And as always, again, this is out of Jesus calling, as if the Lord is writing this directly to us. It says, "Never take for granted my intimate nearness. Marvel at the wonder of my continual presence with you. Even the most ardent human lover cannot be with you always. Nor can another person know the intimacies of your heart, mind, and spirit. I know everything about you, even the number of hairs on your head. You don't need to work at revealing yourself to me. Many people spend a lifetime or a small fortune searching for someone who understands them. Yet I am freely available to all who can call upon my name, who open their hearts to receive me as Savior. This simple act of faith is the beginning of a lifelong love story. I, the lover of your soul, understand you perfectly and love you eternally." Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for that. Only He can love you the way you need to be loved. Amen. At this time, we'd like to sing praises to our King. Amen. We give that a round of applause. The Lord loves when we praise his name in song.
Amen.
He loves it. Amen. This is none of our original music. We did not write any of this music. We do not own the rights to any of this music. Amen. This first song, it means a lot, you know, because the Lord can make a way out of no way. The things that you can't see that might be impossible, that you think is impossible for it to happen, the Lord can make it happen. And we call him the Waymaker. Amen. So this song is called Waymaker. Okay, Wes. It's called Waymaker. Okay, Wes.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper,
Okay, Wes. Continue to bless us. Continue to love us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. This next song is called Turning Around for Me. I do not own the rights to this religion. Okay, Wes. Sometimes discouraged, but not defeated. Cast down, love, not destroyed. There are times I don't understand, but I believe it's turning around for me. Now I've had troubles and disappointments. There are times I felt so alone. Some of my friends they let me down, but I believe it's turning around.
Turning around for me. Matthew chapter 6, verse 25 And I'm going to read quite a bit here, verses 25 through 33. Matthew chapter 6. Verses 25 through 33. Matthew chapter 6. Verses 25 through 33. Hallelujah. When the Lord brought this message to my mind, I was thinking about how I used to be. I used to be concerned. Well, I put it the way it was. I used to worry. But God is now allowing me to worry any longer. When you find it, please stand for the reading of God's word. For those of you who are listening in, if you would please stand to honor God's word. Matthew chapter 6, verses 25 through 33. Hallelujah. And I'm waiting. Hallelujah. Make sure everybody's got it. Praise God. Matthew chapter 6, verses 25 through 33. Thank you, Jesus. Give people time to find the word. Hallelujah. Thank you for helping. Hallelujah. And it says here, therefore, I say to you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? Which of you by worrying can add one cubit to his stature? So why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. And yet I say to you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Now if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For after all these things the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. May God add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, and to the doing of these of his word. The scripture I read, Jesus spoke. He said, don't worry. Don't be concerned. Don't worry is what he said. And I know that in time like today, there's times when gas prices have gone up. Food prices have gone up. It seems like price gouging is going on, and everything around us, it seems like since the pandemic, there has been such a change in everything. Till it's got people having to make a decision as to whether they're going to feed their children or keep their lights on or keep gas in their cars. Everything has gone up, and it's causing those who don't know the Lord to worry. And in some situations, it's causing Christians who know the Lord to be concerned or to worry about what the Lord, what's going on in their lives. But Jesus said, regardless of what the situation may look like, don't worry. We know that Satan's best weapons are worry, fear, and doubt. Some of us has battled one or more of these in our lives, if not all. In Matthew chapter 6, I realized that this was an invitation to rest in the arms of a loving God. Jesus said, don't worry. Jesus said, just like God has clothed the birds of the sky and he's taking care of the fields, if you've ever driven down through the United States in any way, shape, or form, if you've gone past, especially in the spring and the summer, and you see how beautiful the grass is, how beautiful the flowers are, you see the different birds. There are so many different types of birds and butterflies and all types of things, and they're beautiful. If God took care of them, surely he will take care of us. He does not want us to be concerned about anything that's going on. He said, don't be concerned about that. I got that. I got your back. I'll take care of that. And I'm a living witness that he answers and he does take care. So long as we seek ye first the kingdom of God, we need to stay focused on what God wants us to do. Stay focused on his word. Stay focused on what the Lord will have us to do. The scripture that comes to my mind is where it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your mind. And love your neighbor as you love yourself. All he's asking us to do is be obedient to his word. To love your fellow man. To help those that you're able to help. To pray for those that God will send help to those that you're not able to help. But seek him first. Keep him first in your heart and in your mind. And if you do that, everything else is going to come into play. Everything else is going to come to pass. As I was reading this and preparing, there are some things I want you to know. In Matthew 21, 22. It says, and whatever things you ask in prayer, believing you will receive. Again, Jesus is saying, all you got to do is ask in prayer and believe that you will receive what you prayed for. And if it's in God's will, see, sometimes we might pray and it might not be according to the will of God. And even those things don't come to pass, that's when the enemy will bring in doubt. He'll bring in fear because you are praying for something that is not is contrary to what God has for your life. So when we pray, we must pray, God, if it be your will, this is what I desire. God, these are the things. If it's something about take care of my finances and all that, he already said he's going to do that. So when we pray correctly. Seek God's face. Worship him first. Honor him first. Have faith in him first. Believe that he's going to hear your prayer. Then give your request unto God. And then after you give your request, don't pick it back up again when you get up. Leave it in the hands of God. And everything will be all right. He says, whatever things you ask in prayer, believe you will receive them. Also, we have here, so prayer is the key. In Luke 11, 9, it says, so I say to you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. Ask God, whatever it is, you're his child. I don't know of any parent whose child is doing what they want them to do, won't do anything they could to make sure that they give that child the desires of the heart and give them what they need. I don't know of any parent that won't do that so long as their children are being obedient to their word. Now, if you got a child that don't want to listen, if you got a child that every time you turn around, you can call them in some kind of lie, or they acting up in school, or they acting up in any kind of way, I think most parents, well, they would tell them, I said, I was getting ready to get this for you. And I've seen this where I work. I've seen parents say this to their children. I was getting ready to get this for you. But you clowning, you acting up. So I'm going to hold back my blessing until you turn your life around and get it right and get right with what you're supposed to be doing. So it is with the Father. He's not going to throw his blessings. He's not going to throw the things that he desires for us to have on a disobedient child. We got to be in obedience to the Father in order to receive the blessings that he has for us. So when things are held up, he's going to say yes, no, or wait. If it's something that he is saying wait, he's saying wait not because he don't want to give it to you, but he's giving you time to get your life in order so that you can have the desires of your heart. You can have the things that God has for you. He is saying wait so that you can get it right. If he said yes, that means you're going to get it. And he's going to come. But if he said no, I don't care how many prayers you pray. If God has said no to a situation or a thing or whatever it is you desire in your heart, and if it's not according to the word of God or not in the plan that he has for your life, and he has said no, guess what? He is not going to change his mind. It's no. Hallelujah. And we need to accept that. And how will we know what God is wanting us to do? How do we know if God is saying yes, no, or wait? How do we know? We know when we speak to the Father. We know when we are in prayer and we're talking to him and he talks back to us. He's not going to hold anything away from us. He's going to give us the desires of his heart for us. He's going to let us know where he's at with us in our lives. He's going to let us know. I'm saying wait because there's some things that you got to get correct in your life. Or I'm saying no because that's not good for you. I've been there. And I overrode what God said. And I went through hell. H-E double hockey sticks. Because I did not obey God when he said no. I said yes. And I went on about my business and did something that God had already said no. And we don't realize when God said no, and we do it anyway, he's going to say, okay, you got it. Go right ahead. The angel's hands are tied. The Holy Spirit won't say nothing. He's not going to speak because God said no, and he told us no, and we're still doing what we want to do. Guess what? You on your own. And I don't know anybody that can make it on their own without the Father. And we get ourselves in situations, and then we end up crying, Lord, have mercy. And God was, I told you no. But you got out there, but guess what? He's a loving God. He's a loving God. He might take us to the woodshed. He might allow us to stay in a situation or stay in that trouble that we're in a little while longer. But eventually we're going to come out. And eventually he's going to dust us off. He's going to say, okay, I love you still, even though you disobeyed me, I love you. And if you've repented, I love you. And I'm going to help you through this situation. You're going to remember what I told you no, and you said yes. You're going to remember it because he's going to allow us to be in that situation long enough that we'll get to the point and say, God, you get me out of this. I'll never do this again. I'll never disobey your word again. He'll let us go through a little tribulation. He'll let us go through it because he wants us to realize and recognize his word is truth. Yes, no, or wait. And whatever God has said, when you ask him, when you seek his face, when you knock on the door of heaven, God will honor your prayer. He will answer your prayer. And when he gives you the answer, be ready and willing to accept it. Don't allow fear, doubt, or especially worry to get in your situation, because that's not where God would have you to be. Hallelujah. We need to depend on Jesus. There's a song, you can't depend on Jesus, and everything is going to be all right. And that's so true. We have to depend. Depend says to place reliance or trust. Reliance. We rely on his word. We trust that he has our best interest at heart. We're going to do what God has called us to do. Hallelujah. We can't put reliance and trust in man, because man is just like us. Man, we're human. And then we're going to trust another human? That human has got ideas and thoughts just like we have ideas and thoughts. But our ways may not be God's ways. And our thoughts may not be God's thoughts. So we have to depend and trust in the one that will not do anything to harm us. The one that loves us unconditionally. The one that's going to be there regardless of what our situation is. And that one is God the Father. That one is Jesus the Son, who gave his life to free us. That one is the Holy Spirit that leads, guides, and directs us through life today. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Three distinct individuals, yet they are one. We have to remember that and recognize that. And know that Jesus loves us in spite of what we do. That God loves us in spite of what we do. That the Holy Spirit loves us in spite of what we do. And they're all looking at us and saying, this is my child whom I love. And I want to help them. I want to make sure that their lives are in order. Hallelujah. We've got to stop worrying about today. Stop worrying about tomorrow. Stop worrying about what's going on. But we need to keep our minds stayed on Jesus. We need to trust in our Father. Don't allow the devil to keep us in hell on earth. And then we end up in hell on the last days. My son spoke to you about our Bible study on Revelations. A lot of preachers don't want to preach Revelations. A lot of people don't want to read Revelations because the enemy has used something else that he used, and that's fear. A lot of people don't understand Revelations, but they don't want to take the time. They're not taking the time to ask God to open up that book to their hearts and their minds so they'll understand it. A lot of people fear reading it. When God has said, blessed are those who read this chapter. Blessed are those. I just want to throw that in to let you know that that's something. If you can't get into our sessions on Revelation, read that book because it's important. And don't have fear about that book. Don't worry in any way, shape, or form about anything that comes your way. I'm going to tell you, I'm a living witness. I'm a living witness. I used to. Now, my kids would tell you, I would sit up there and work in 2-3 jobs trying to make ends meet and worrying about how we're going to do this or how we're going to do that or how am I going to get them here or how am I going to pay this or pay. Worry, the enemy, I would be eaten up with that. And God gave me a scripture when I got saved, but it seemed like that scripture went out of my mind. He gave me in Proverbs 3:5, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. And I seemed like when I was having my kids were young and I was working all those hours, and it seemed like my money was just going through a sieve. It seemed like I get paid today, and I had one of those cars. I don't know if y'all remember the Ford Granada. Ford, fix or repair daily. That's what I was doing. It seemed like that car knew my paycheck. And every time I got paid, I had to fix something on that car. And I would come home, Lord, what's going on? I'm trying to live for you. I'm trying to do right. But got me in trouble. I let my butt get me in trouble. Because instead of believing and trusting God and knowing that he was going to make a way, which he always did. He always did. We didn't want for nothing. He always made a way. I sit there and worried about something that I shouldn't have been worried about because he always made a way. I allowed my butts to negate God's word. I would sit there, Lord, I know what your word said, but I allowed my butts to get in the way. And God let me know it's not about what you are thinking. It's not about how, it's about how you're praying. It was about how I was praying. Because I was praying amiss. I was not praying according to God's word. I was not standing on his word. And every time he showed me what I repented, the thing that I was praying about came right on in. And he would just say, didn't I say trust in me with all your heart? That means everything within us, we got to trust God. We can't lean to this mind. Because his mind will mess you up. Your mind is a battlefield of the enemy. And he will allow you to think and see things that is not of God, that's contrary to his word, to trip you up, to keep you from trusting him with all your heart. Don't lean to the mind, your understanding. Acknowledge who God is. God is my Alpha and my Omega. God is my beginning and my end. God is my joy, my love, my comforter, my peace, my salvation. He's my all in all. He's a wheel in the middle of a wheel. He's there when nobody else is there. He's my joy. He's everything that I need. Everything when I call on him, he's going to answer my prayer. We need to think about who he is and who we are in him. He loves us. The angels even ask him, God, who is man that you're so mindful of them? And he let them know we are his children, called by his name. If we are children of God, we must believe, hallelujah, in our Father. Believe that he loves us. Believe he's never going to leave us or forsake us. Believe that he is going to be there. Get the peace of God in your heart. Get the joy that the devil can't take, this world can't take away from you. Walk in the joy and the peace and the favor of God. Be obedient to his word and you will see that everything he says, everything he does is going to be all right. Don't get caught up in worry. Don't get caught up in fear. The only fear we should have is the fear of not doing what God said in his word. Don't get caught up in doubt. Be caught up in the fact that your Father loves you. He knows what you're in need of. Be obedient to his word and ask him. He wants us to ask him. Hallelujah. Even though he knows, we need to ask God. And God will hear us. It says in John 14:14, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. This is Jesus talking. If you ask anything in the name of Jesus, we won't get it asking and not utilizing the name of Jesus. But if we say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you and I ask for this thing according to your word. This is what you said you was going to do for me. I'm standing on your word because your word is saying and your word is truth. And I'm going to stand on your word. I'm going to believe in your word. I'm not going to put a timetable on you because you know what time I need. Whatever it is that I need, you know the time. You know the date. You know when it's coming. And I trust you, God, to be there in my time of need. And he'll be there. We just got to trust and obey. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Happy holidays from all of us at Parkview Health.
Yeah. Community Radio 95.7 FM WELT is interrupting our regular programming for this special feature. Today, community and public radio stations across America will come together in a simultaneous broadcast of John Lennon's timeless song of peace, unity, and hope, Give Peace a Chance. This collective transmission serves to unite radio listeners from coast to coast in a unified demonstration to support those around the world who are affected by war, reminding us all that we can collectively amplify support for peace across the globe. Community and public radio together for peace. This is Community Radio 95.7 FM WELT.
2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah.
We now return you to your regular programming here on Community Radio, 95.7 FM, WELT.
Temple. Holy is the Lord.
Amen. We cry, holy, holy is the Lord. Savior be glory, majesty, dominion, and power.